Last week, Dr. Jayalakshmi was talking about continuous acupressure can solve the problem of long-standing acute pressure at the end. We are in a situation like this. Every organization, every system has built-in checks and balances. It has its own audit committees, vigilance commissions, procedures, rules, checks, everything. If you have worked in a public sector organization, you will find at different levels there are checks being used to avoid the kind of thing we are talking about at a large scale, corruption or nepotism or mistakes. We are now talking about one end where everything has been allowed to accumulate. We are trying to solve. We are talking about 0000 crores attached to everything. Whereas, if we simultaneously work on the system which should stop, prevent, reduce or marginalize these issues, that is equally important. We are not focusing as much on that. There are existing systems. There is nothing new required. If you go to Reserve Bank of India, there are other manuals, what to do? See, there is some kind of an imbalance in the processing on a day-to-day basis, the execution and ultimatization. Even in the parliament, even in the ministry's functioning, there are enough checks and balances. If Prime Minister's office did not see things, overlooked everything and then allowed it to 1,76,000 crores, Raja alone is not responsible. So, we are now focusing on Raja and the rest of the people can conveniently go to Honolulu for holiday. No, this is a problem.
I think that's what you said is very important. Also, many times, I won't say we as a country alone, I mean I think it's true everywhere, and general human tendency seems to be that when you find that a particular system that is set up has problems, the first inclination is to throw the system and create a new system, as if the new system will not have its problems. Usually when you have a new system, the new system will have its own new problems. It sounds nice because we don't know the problems and its issues. That the issue is, this looks like it is bad because we know the problems. And the harder job seems to be to actually go down and say, okay, let's correct the problems, let's make the system work. Seems like a much harder job. And it sounds much better that throw this away and get a new one. But the new one is not going to solve it, is what we'll have to recognize. And we have to do the harder job of clearing this. I mean, that's like, for example, we have a Panchayati Raj bill, which has not been implemented.
Exactly.
If you, as long as you have huge amounts of money sitting in the state government, there is a chance for corruption. If you actually
this
decentralize
is what
it,
you are talking about, local government, local responsibility, local disbursement, etc. Nobody has even talked about it and the minister gets changed.
Yeah. No, and it's not easy and it has its issues. But I'm saying you can't say, okay, now it has its issues, let me throw it away and go to the next bill. Like when we are talking about working with the education system, at one stage we had this, a friend of mine who told me, 25 years ago when I went and talked to the education department officials, they said, we had all these problems earlier, now we have this new thing, wait for another 3-4 years and things will all be very good. 15 years later and again I went and talked to them, they said, earlier what all we did was wrong, now we have changed the whole thing, now we have got a new system and now onwards it will be very good. And recently when we went and talked to them, they said the exact same thing. So at every stage they are saying what all happened in the past is junk, we'll throw it out, get a new system. It'll take you a long time to figure out why the new system is wrong. And by the time you figure it out, you'll say, oh, this is wrong, throw it out, get the new system. And I think that direction is a problem. And so trying to work on how existing systems have gaps and to fill them and to change them, I think is as important as introducing new systems. I'm not saying no new system is required. Like I think a watchdog function like Lokpal Bill is definitely required. And again, it's not new, it has been there from 1968, they've been proposing it so many times. Just that the push is needed, but there is no shortcut. I mean, the only way we can make this country non-corrupt or make it accountable, and corruption is one issue, accountability, make it deliver proper governance, requires that everybody be active and actually push at the local level. It's a lot of hard work. And there is no shortcut saying that we don't do the hard work and somehow we'll get solved. I think that is not the work.
Are the activists are being killed? You said, you know, the parliament can, it's for 5 years and so on. Even if this goes through and if it is not going to work, they can still change it, right? So, rather than saying that what will be 15-year, 20-year impact and so on, they still have the power to change the constitution, right? If that is what is required.
Yeah.
So, don't you think it should be a step by which, in some form or other, they should govern by which accountability starts in the first place.
No, no, I think
it makes things change.
Yeah, no, no, I am not at all. In fact, I am very strongly supporting that we should have a Lokpal Bill. Okay, exactly what should the clauses of the Lokpal Bill are the places to argue. Like, for example, I don't agree that the Lokpal Bill should actually look at public grievance. I think it should look at corruption and it should look at top level corruption for it to actually focus. I don't think that Lokpal Bill should take on the responsibility of doing the CVC thing, but from top to bottom, they have so many vigilance officers everywhere. Those are specific clauses, but should there be a Lokpal Bill? Yes. I don't think there is, and I don't think anybody is saying we should not have a Lokpal Bill.
The only concern is if it doesn't happen now, I think it'll, next 5 years you'll push it through.
I agree. No, I agree. And I think it should be done reasonably quickly.
Right.
And just like you say, we can always modify it. If you come up with a Lokpal Bill which has certain aspects and does not have other aspects, it can also be modified to add on those aspects later, which is also going to be hard. But I mean, it works both ways. But people feel like one time you bring the bill, you don't change it. So that is also.
Do you think a Lokpal Bill at every state? I mean, it may not be feasible.
The Lokayukta, yeah.
Lokayukta in every state. Would that be a good state?
We have Lokayuktas in 18 states.
Yeah. They are not doing anything.
We already have 18 states Lokayukta.
But what are they doing?
Even the
no, but why do we think that Lokpal will be able to do it? It's exactly the problem.
No,
they will do to some extent, but they won't be able to. See, the assumption that they will, having somebody like this will solve the entire problem. It's like saying having a very good Chief Justice will solve the entire problem.
Right? Saying you had in Panchayat Raj, you had local bills, but systems are there, but the functioning aren't there because corruption is there.
Or it's actually a connected problem.
Yeah.
Corruption is there because these are not, it's both. Like for example, I feel strongly that if the Panchayati Raj Act actually gets implemented, there are gaps, they'll have to debate it, they'll have to do it. Then the amount of money sitting with the government here, whether it's DMK, ADMK, whoever, is actually much less. So you don't even have that money to be corrupt. Now you'll have to be corrupt at all Panchayat levels, and then the next step that you actually ask Gram Sabhas to come audit accounts, has the road been laid? See, right now no road may be laid, they will say there was a road laid. But if you have a Gram Sabha, maximum you can be corrupt is to have a road and it can be a bad road. Bad road versus no road, the amount of corruption gets minimized. And if people are watchful, they can say, why bad road? Next time I will not elect you, I will not push you there.
Can write when you have a medicine, you have expiry date, you should write a road, expiry road.
Exactly. The more public you make information, the more people will be able to participate, the better it is. But there is no shortcut to people participating. Ultimately, they get affected. So unless we participate, they're not going to be able to address the issue. So my biggest problem with the campaign itself is getting mobilizing so many people, which was great, and then telling them that the solution lies not in their doing acts to basically get things done, but pushing for one thing and after which the whole thing will get solved. I think that sounded, that was the one which got so many people, but somewhere it seems to kind of dilute the entire point of the campaign. When we should actually tell people, well, all of you come together, and it's a hard job to solve. But like the freedom struggle wasn't won by saying everybody supports somebody to go and break their head. The whole point of the freedom struggle is each of us go and break our heads. It's a big step. For people to break salt laws all over the place is a huge step. And that empowered so many people to actually do things locally and push for things locally. Builds courage, confidence locally. And I think that this movement is not moving in that direction. That's the biggest
thank you, everybody. Thank you.